This color's all wrong. It looks like a stuck pig bled all over my hand.
Well, I'm sure I have something. Do you have pink?
Of course I have pink. Well, it has to be delicate.
Well, if I don't have something, we'll send one of the boys to get you some.
Great idea, Mama. I'd love to see what the boys would pick out.
Oh, is he trying to drive me crazy? Boys, don't put ice down my back.
Should have drowned him at first. Guess what I found in the hall closet? Rubbers. The boys are going to decorate the car. Well, please stop them.
Boys, don't you decorate your sister's car with condoms. It's tacky. Shelby, please help me.
Mama, my nails are wet.
Boys, we're off to Truvies. Tommy, I want you to keep an eye on your brother.
Am I my brother's keeper?
You're your brother's warden is what you are. Where's your father?
Coffee, Mr. Keithy.
Shelby, let's go.
Mama, I said I'd be right there.
What?
Mama, it's Miss Weezer.
Let's go out the front.
I think there's someone at the door.
I think it's for Dad.
Oops, I see a hole.
Oh, I was hoping you'd catch that.
Now, it's a little poofier than I would normally do, but I'm nervous.
Oh, honey, I wouldn't worry about that. When I go to bed, I normally wrap my entire head in toilet tissue, so it usually gets a little smushed down anyway in that process.
In my class at the trade school, I was number one when it came to frosting and streaking. I even did my own.
Really? That's good. I can usually spot a bottle job at 20 paces. Well, honey, your technique is good, and I think your form and content will improve with time. So from what I can just tell, you have just landed yourself a job.
Oh,
honey, no time now, and this morning we are going to be busier than a one-off paper hanger.
Thank you, Miss Trivy. Thank you so
much.
Oh,
you have been here not a moment too soon. Now, would you be a treasure? You know where the coffee stuff is. Everything else is next to the stove. And now, honey, this is the most successful shop in town. You want to know why?
Why?
Because I have a strict philosophy that I have stuck to for 15 years. There is no such thing as natural beauty. That is why I have never lost a client to the cutting curl or the beauty box. And now, honey, remember my ladies only against the best. Do not scrimp on anything. Feel free to use as much hairspray as you like.
There's no such thing as natural beauty.
Remember that, Annette, or we are all out of a job. Why, just look at me, honey. It takes some effort to look like this.
Well, I can see that. Now, how many ladies do we have this morning?
Well, I restrict myself to the ladies of the neighborhood on Saturday mornings. Normally, that would be just three, but today we've got Shelby Eaton. she's not a regular. She's the daughter of a regular. I have to do something wondrous with her hair. She is getting married this afternoon. Yeah, I know.
Well, I just moved to town a few weeks ago.
Really? Well, go on. Tell me things about yourself.
Well, there's nothing to tell. I live here now, and I've got a job, and that's it. Can I borrow a few of these back issues of Southern Hair?
Why, sure. I think it is essential to keep abreast of the latest styles. I get McCall's, Family Circle, Glamour, Mademoiselle, every magazine known to man. Now, honey, you must live close by. Within walking distance, I mean. I didn't see a car.
My car? I don't have a car. I've been staying across the river at Robeline's boarding house.
Well, that's quite a walk. Ruth Robeline. Now there's the story. She's a twisted, troubled soul. Her entire life has been an experiment in terror. Her husband was killed in World War I. Then her son got killed in Vietnam. I tell you, when it comes to suffering, she is right up there with Elizabeth Taylor.
Well, I had no idea. Is that a gunshot?
Oh, why, yes, it is, dear. Would you go plug in the hair dryer, please?
But why is someone firing a gun in a nice neighborhood like this?
It has to do with Shelby and her father. You'll be a lot better off if you just ignore it like the rest of the neighborhood.
Good morning,
Clarice. Why, good morning, Clarice. I tried to call and tell you I was running late. There was no answer.
Well, honey, I was at the high school. I have been up since the crack of dawn.
Oh. And now, I would like you to meet the former First Lady of Schlinkle Pen, Miss Belcher. Clarice, this is Annelle. She has taken Judy's place.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, honey, if I knew I was meeting new people, I'd have taken a little more pride in my appearance. I was at the dedication of our town's new football field. I'm not usually this windblown.
And now they named the new field after her late husband, Lloyd Belcher Memorial Coliseum. That team has voted her all sorts of titles.
And I have the pom-poms to prove it. Now, honey, what's your name?
Well, my married name's Dupuy.
Well, I don't think I know any Dupuys.
I just moved here. I'm originally from Zwali.
Oh, that explains it. Well, truly, I thought I brought you those recipes.
Well, Corinne, the reason I called is, do you mind if I do Shelby first?
Oh, honey, I don't mind. I'll amuse myself. Shelby is the most important one today. That man, I swear, I think the situation is worse than ever.
I totally agree. And now, I think we're going to need some more wash towels. Would you get in there stacked up next to the machine?
Wait, gal, where'd you find us?
Well, she heard I had a position open and she just walked right in. I think there's a story here.
Ooh, what makes you say that?
Well, for starters, she's married, but she lives at Ruth Robeline's. Alone?
Honey, I'd get to the bottom of this if I were you. You have some nice silverware you like to keep.
Marie, I'm
not worried about that. She's just as sweet as you can be.
But I just love the idea of hiring someone with a past.
Honey, she can't be more than 18. She hasn't had time to have a past.
Marie, this is the 80s. Get with it.
If you can achieve puberty, you can achieve a past. Oh.
Well, here you go.
Thanks, honey.
Oh, are those recipes?
They are.
Now, this one sounds delicious.
Oh, it is, and the Bisquick makes it so simple.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's see. Now, here's another one for my daughter-in-law. She said you can't attend a function in Tickfall with it and stuff.
Oh, now let me see. Are these chocolate chips semi-sweet or milk?
Milk.
Is the caro sap light or dark?
Matter of taste.
Now, where's that one you were telling me about, the cuppa?
Oh, honey, you don't have to write that down. It's a cup of flour, cup of sugar, cup of fruit cocktail with the juice. You mix up and bake at 350 till golden bubbly.
Well, that sounds awfully rich.
It is. So I serve it over ice cream because it's sweet.
Oh.
Well, give me some paper, honey, and I'll copy it down for you.
Well, as I was saying, she may not be an international spy, but if she works out, I may let her rent the garage apartment.
But I thought the boys were going to live there while they go to college.
Oh, no, recent developments. Louie's going away to college now, and Poot's going to work for my cousin in Baltimore. My babies are growing up. He doesn't want to be called Poot anymore.
Oh, honey, you look so good. I can't believe your children are old enough to leave the nest.
Well, I was a child bride, you know. Well, I'll look at the bright side of things. I do have some places to visit now. You know, I've always wanted to go to Baltimore. I am told it's the hairdo capital of the world.
Well, where's that paper?
I have no idea, honey.
Let's see, I think I might have some. I can just write it down for you myself.
Why, thank you, sweetheart. Come. Now, as I was saying, Shelby, and now, this morning we are going to have her. It is going to be beautiful, her whole entire reception. I'll just let you find out later.
I do love weddings.
Oh, really? Are you married?
I do hope that coffee's better.
Would you go get us some, please?
Sure. Well, honey, when are they coming?
I have no idea. It's okay. Oh, well, there she is. Speak of the devil. Come here and break my neck.
Rosie, it's so good to see you.
Morning, Miss Clarice.
Morning.
It's not that I'm unfriendly. I was just worried about my nails.
Oh, that is such a pretty color.
Well, I hope it doesn't dry too dark. If it's too dark, it'll never do. You know, the colors are never the same as they are on the bottle.
Oh, you always find that to be true.
This color is drawn way too dark. Practically pink my foot. Truby, do you have those nail polish remover things?
Oh, I'm sure I have some here somewhere. Where is your mama? Oh, there you go.
Well, right behind me, I thought. Oh, hi. I'm Shelby Eatington. Soon to be Lester.
Hi, I'm a nail. I'm new.
Well, a nail, you're working with the best. Anyone who's anybody gets the head done at Truby.
That is absolutely right. Honey, you know I would walk on my lips to avoid criticizing anybody, but your father is about to make us all pull our hair out, and that is bad for my business.
Well, he should be finished with his yard work soon.
I hope so.
You're not the only one concerned. Mama's about to have a fit. Her and Daddy have been fighting like cats and dogs.
Honey, they're just anxious with so much going on.
No, they're not. They're just trying to create as much tension as possible in any given situation. It's a creed they live by.
You know, I was reading an article in Glamour about tension during family occasions. It seems there can be a lot of stress and trauma. But the thing I found most interesting is that stressful times can unleash deep, dark hostilities that make your hair fall out.
Oh, Truby, can I borrow that recipe of strawberry pie?
Oh, why, you sure can.
Well, Mama and Daddy are fighting about patio furniture. Jackson and I will never fight about such stupid things.
Oh.
Are you married or nail?
Oh, I hope that coffee's better. Oh, how pretty.
Princess Grey. Now, honey, did you bring me that picture like I asked?
Here it is.
Oh,
study it carefully. Here's the magic.
Oh, this is so exciting. I feel like I am present at the creation. I feel that there is something so wondrous about the way a bride looks. I feel it is beauty in its purest form. Shelby, honey, just out of curiosity, where am I going to put that baby's breath? There is none in this picture.
Oh, you just stick it in. It's meant to frame my face. Baby's breath is part of my whole decoration concept for a total romantic look.
Well, Miss Clarice, what cute shoes?
Oh, honey, you think so? I think they're a little too racy for me. I'll probably get rid of them.
Oh, Miss Clarice, those are too cha-cha for words. If you decide to give them away, I'll buy them from you.
Well, honey, what size do you wear?
Well, in a good shoe, I wear a size 6, but a 7 feels so good, I buy a size 8.
The 8.5.
Perfect.
Morning.
Well, good morning, Malin.
Hi, Mama. Look at Miss Clarice's shoes.
They're mine.
It's just a riddle.
And now this is my mama. How are things at the house?
Fine. We've the Boudreaux just a second drop by to see your father. One of both of them is probably lying in a pool of blood by now.
Here now, look.
How's the mother of the bride?
Don't ask.
Oh, well, what's the matter?
Well, nothing. A handful of Christmas drugs can it take care of.
Oh. And now, will you go on and shampoo Miss Eaton? And these girls have mountains to move today.
Ain't that the truth?
Hook off your card is on top.
Oh, piece of cake.
Well, is there anything I can do at the last minute?
Oh, you've done plenty, Clary. I think we've got everything situated. We just finished borrowing every fire in North Louisiana.
Well, I sure do hope that rain holds off. Shelby, I'm sorry it wasn't a prettier day.
Oh, this is perfect weather for me. I don't function well when it's hot. I love cloudy days.
On cloudy days, I feel God's not trying very hard, so I don't have to either.
She does sweat profusely.
Thank you, Mama.
You know, heat never bothers me. I love it. But spicy foods make me sweat, especially on the top of my head. My hair gets wet.
I'll get it.
I'll bet that's for me. It's probably my mind trying to locate my body.
Oh, Malin.
Hello?
Yes, sir, she is. Hold on a minute. Malin, it's your husband.
Yes, Drum. Drum, I don't know. Drum, I don't have it. For the last time, I don't know where it is, Drum. Ask the boys. Okay, goodbye.
What did Daddy want?
Oh, nothing.
So, Shelby, we're going to sweep half of it up and leave a little softness around your ears?
Yes. Sweep it up.
Yes, Mama, up, like Princess Grace.
Did you bring Trudy the picture of Jacqueline Smith?
No, I brought the picture of Princess Grace. I destroyed the picture of Jacqueline Smith.
But I thought I made you understand the advantages of the Jacqueline Smith hairdo.
No, Mama.
Well, at least I talked her out of that stupid idea of sticking baby's breath on her hair.
Keep your head still, please.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Fine, I find water refreshing. It just startled me a little, that's all.
Okay.
Well, honey, do you have any more recipes I can have? I'm starving.
Oh, why, sure, honey. They're just in there. I'll get them for you in a second.
All right.
Shelby, tell us things about Jackson. Your mama doesn't tell us one thing.
He's really cute. Thought he was a pest at first, but then he kind of grew on me, and now I love him.
Well, where did you meet him?
At a party at the Petroleum Club in Shreveport. I had no idea who he was, but I was getting a big kick out of him watching him on the dance floor. Painfully obvious, he had never taken the time to watch himself dance in front of a mirror. And there was something so attractive about how stupid he looked.
Is he real romantic?
No, but he does give me flowers and a little present if I bug him enough. He has promised to give me a red rose on every anniversary corresponding to the number of that anniversary. I think that's so sweet.
Well, that's a pretty romantic idea, isn't it, girl?
Well, yes. I wish it had been his. Lord and I missed it for 50 years by 3 months. Bless his heart. He just couldn't make it.
Miss Clarice, do you remember your wedding?
Oh, honey, I remember everything about my wedding. The flowers, the food.
Weeza was my maid of honor.
Oh, Shelby, I hope you and Jackson will be as happy as Lord and I were. We had so much fun together until last November. Well, at least we held on through the state playoffs.
Miss Clarice, there are still good times to be had.
Oh, I guess, but I miss the whirlwind of being a mayor's wife. I don't like to go to things by myself and just be one. And if I go with a couple, I'm a third wheel. And if I go with a few friends, we're just a couple of old biddies.
Somebody like you should be able to find something to occupy your time.
Well, I really do love football, but it's hard to parlay that into a reason to live.
Clarice, you are a woman coming to grips with her terms. You and I are in the same boat. My kids are leaving town, and I have a husband that hasn't moved from in front of a television set in 15 years. It is up to you and I to decide what we were put on this earth. Ladies, that is today's sermon. So, Shelby, are you going to live in West Monroe or Monroe proper with Jackson?
Oh, Monroe, of course. His law practice is there.
Ooh, Shelby, you are lucky. Louisiana lawyers do well with well, whether they want to or not.
Oh, I don't really care. Don't get me wrong. The money's real nice, but I just like the idea of growing old with somebody. My dream is to get old and sit on a back porch covered with grandchildren and say no and stop that.
Are you going to quit nursing?
Never. I love it. I love being around all those babies.
Oh. Drum and I feel that Shelby should not work after she gets married.
Well, I'm so anxious to discuss this topic for the 900th time this week.
You should not be on your feet all day. You should be kinder to your circulatory system.
And now, I know you're new and all, but don't let that stop you. Time you have something to say, just let her rip.
Oh, I don't have anything to say.
Well, Malin, it looks like you're ready to roll. I think we can trust the nail to roll you up. Why, Nell, do you think you can roll up, Malin?
Well, I don't know. Today is very special, and my work tends to be too poofy when I'm nervous. Does your dress have to go over your head?
No.
Good.
Don't worry. You can't scrub her hair. You just tease it and make it look like a blonde football helmet.
Well, I must have missed the passage in Emily Post that said all abuse is heaped on the mother of the bride. Go ahead, Anel. I'm sure you'll do a beautiful job.
Okay.
Well, Shelby, you all hush. Tell us things about the wedding. How many bridesmaids?
None.
Good Lord.
Exactly.
I hope that photographer brings a wide-angle lens.
Well, I think it's embarrassing and awful, but Mama made me have my cousins and Margie St. Maurice.
Shelby, there was no way around it, and you know it.
It will be pretentious, and Daddy always says an ounce of pretension worth a pound of manure.
The poet laureate of Dogwood Lane.
Mama, I wish you'd get off Daddy's back. He gets enough hassle from Miss Weezer.
What are your colors, Shelby?
They're blush and bashful.
Oh. Her colors are pink and pink.
My colors are blush and bashful, Mama.
I ask you, how precious is this wedding going to get?
My colors are blush and bashful. I have chosen two shades of pink when it's much deeper than the other.
Well, the bridesmaids' dresses, they're really beautiful.
Ceremony will be too. All the walls are banked with sprays of flowers, and my two shades of blush and bashful. Pink carpet specially laid out for my service, and pink so punting, draped over anything that would stand still.
The sanctuary looks like it's been hosed down with Pepto-Bismol.
I like pink. Pink is my signature color.
What about the reception, Shelby?
My reception burns in twinkly lights. There'll be magnolias in the pool.
Let's just hope your father doesn't need magnolias from Louisa's side of the tree.
Well, the wedding cake will be by the pool, and the groom's cake will be hidden in the carport.
Shelby and I agree on one thing.
The groom's cake.
It's awful. It's in the shape of a giant armadillo.
An armadillo?
Jackson wanted a cake in the shape of an armadillo, and he has an aunt that makes them.
Well, it's unusual.
It's repulsive. It has gray icing. I can't even think of how you'd make gray icing.
Worse, the cake part is red velvet cake. Blood red. People are going to be hacking in this poor animal. Looks like he's boiling to death.
The rehearsal supper was an experience.
Mama, it wasn't that bad. That at Jackson's uncle's place on the river.
For dinner, they served steak and potatoes. They went to a lot of trouble.
His family loves to barbecue.
And Jackson's from a good old Southern family with good old Southern values. Either shoot it, stuff it, or marry it.
Well, they're simply outdoors at that time.
Well, did you all do anything especially romantic?
We drove down to Franklin's Point on talking.
Oh, Shelby.
Well, then we went skinny dipping and did things that frightened the fish.
This is my favorite part. This is the romantic part.
Ooh,
this is what really
honey.
Melts my butter.
Honey, it's been a long time since we've had a youngster in the place. We talked and talked and talked.
Oh, I love those kind of talks. In the arms of the man you love.
Well, actually, we fought most of the time.
What?
Well, because I told him I wouldn't marry.
What?
Well, honey, why would you go and do a thing like that? Well, it's okay now. We worked it all out.
Oh, it was just one of those last-minute jitter things.
No, the wedding's still on.
Well, honey, I hope so, because this is going to be in the Hairdo Hall of Fame.
Well, honey, you scared us. You should never do something like that to your mama. You should never say something like that to someone who's been marinating 50 pounds of crab claws.
Miss Lynn, you have very nice hair, and your scalp is clean as a whistle.
Well, thank you. I try.
Oh, I tell you, girls, it must run in the family. This girl has the prettiest head of hair that I have ever had my hands on. It is so thick and gorgeous. Well, honey, just because I am bragging on you doesn't mean you can get lazy on me. Hold your head up.
Stop it.
Well, Shelby? Malia?
I'll get the juice.
Trivia, there's some candy in my face.
I have some. It's right here.
Shelby, we'll get you some juice.
Shelby, hold on. Clarice getting you some juice.
Stop it, Mom.
Hold on.
Here's Clarice. Hold on.
Yeah, honey.
Shelby,
hold on. Mama, Shelby, I have candy in my purse.
Oh, honey. Shelby,
drink the juice, Shelby,
honey,
please.
Well,
drink
who
some juice.
Blame that juice after a peppermint?
Shelby, honey, drink.
Shelby, you need some juice.
Drink. You don't leave me alone. I'm going
to
leave.
Oh. I'd love to.
Oh, honey,
cooperate.
It's just all this wedding and running around and nonsense.
Should I call the doctor?
No. It's
honey, she's a diabetic.
Hurry, Shelby, honey, drink,
she's
please.
She's got a little too much insulin, that's all.
Shelby, honey, just a minute. There you go, honey, drink. There's
there we go. Well, honey, this one hit her fast. She could have hurt herself,
drink
Malia. What if she'd been driving a car?
Perhaps that explains why I have so much gray hair. But you've known Shelby as long as I have. You know we have to let her be strong. I know she's not down too deep.
Say something to us, Shelby.
No.
Well, honey, that's good enough. He's been so upset lately. Her and Jackson have been going round and round. Dr. McCall told her last appointment that children are not possible. It wasn't the easiest thing in the world to sit there and watch a child's heart break.
Don't talk about me like I'm not here.
Now she's making some sense.
Should I do something?
Oh,
could I?
No. It'll be fine in just a minute. Normality is very important to Shelby.
I am so sorry to hear about the child part, Malian.
She feels like Jackson's given up his chance for children. They've talked about it, and he seems to have taken it just fine.
Shelby's the one that's pushing the issue.
He said shut up and don't be stupid. There's plenty of kids out there who have good homes. We got 10 of them. Bomb if we have to.
Well, Jackson sounds like good people to me.
I knew right then and there he was dumb enough to spend the rest of his life with me, then I was dumb enough to marry him. Mama, I'm sorry. Sorry, Mama.
Drink it, dear, honey.
I'm sorry.
Oh, honey, it's okay. We'll fix it. We'll fix it. Just sit up straight, okay, honey? Now, are you want me to put it up after the reception? I'll be glad to give you a touch-up.
Then I'll leave it up as long as possible.
Oh. Now, where's your honeymoon going to be at? I picture somewhere secluded, moonlight for days. Somewhere where you can be intimate out of doors.
Las Vegas.
Oh. Well, I hear the weather's supposed to be real nice. You know, I hear it's like living in a blow dryer.
Shelby, what Jackson said about children, about adoption.
Mama, I don't want to talk about it. What happens now is between Jackson and me. Jackson will take care of me and I'll take care of him.
Now, honey, you can't be mad for people being concerned about you.
Shelby, what Jackson said about children, about adoption, it was wonderful and very wise. Not being able to have children is no disgrace, honey.
Mama, I know all about adoption, and I also know the limitations of this body of mine. I never do anything stupid.
Finally, she's listening to reason.
Now, Shelby, honey, would you untangle this baby's breath for me?
Shelby, no.
Mama, it's my wedding. I'll stick baby's breath up my nose if I want to.
Malia, she has enough.
I'm supposed to be the expert on behavior, and I can't even seem to control my own family.
Oh, did you tell him, Mama?
Tell us what?
Oh, it's nothing, really. I might be promoted to administrator of the Mental Guidance Center.
Oh! Man, congratulations, honey. That's wonderful. The Mental Guidance Center helps so many disturbed people.
Yes, I wish they could have helped my children when they were younger. I should have known Louis had problems when his imaginary playmates wouldn't play with him.
Truvy, your boys grew up fine. They're just a little scary, that's all.
Oh, Shelby. Now, Malin, girls, I tell you what, I think it must be exciting for Malin to have access to all this secret personal information. Malin, come on. Give us some of your most bizarre mental cases and let us guess who they are. There are some pretty sick tickets in this town.
I will not discuss office business in a social setting.
Mama, people come to us and load their problems.
I will not violate their confidence.
When Mama says she doesn't talk, she means it. She's a brick wall.
Well, honey, you know what they say. You can't say something nice about somebody, come sit by me.
Shelby, you gonna finish off the juice?
I'm fine. Well, honey, you know it's gonna be a long time before that bridesmaid luncheon. You better drink some more.
Truvy, you know what you need here. You need a radio. Music is a wonderful thing to have in the background. It takes the pressure off that body feeling they have to talk so much.
Well, I used to have one, but I slammed it against that wall when I couldn't figure out where the batteries went. I know now that I was the victim of premenstrual syndrome.
What did I hear? Oh, yes, the Ann Tilly family is selling their radio station, KPPD. I wonder how much radio stations sell for these days.
A lot, but a small town radio station can be a license to print money if it's ran right.
Miss Clary, you should buy KPPD. You got plenty of money.
Oh, honey, what would I do with a radio station? I never really liked business that much. Lloyd took care of all that stuff.
Shelby, honey, why don't you finish off that juice?
Mama, forget the damn juice.
There's somebody coming. A strange lady with a strange dog.
Oh, that would be Weezer.
What kind of dog is that?
Well,
it's ugly.
Well, if Red had hair, it'd be a dog.
Oh, give us strength.
This is it. I have found it. I'm in hell.
Good morning, Weezer.
Stop crying on my good side, Trudy. I no longer have one.
Well, you're pretty early, aren't you?
That is precisely why I'm here.
You are not expected till 11.
I have to take my dog to bed. Before he has another break.
Weeza, I'm so sorry about all this nonsense.
Not your fault, Molly Ann. I used to think that you were crazy for marrying that man. Then I thought for a few years you were just a glutton for punishment. Now I realize you must be on some mission from God.
Weeza, you need something else to think about besides that dumb animal.
Put a lid on it, Clary. I walked outside this morning to find my naked magnolia fruit. When I saw drum across the way, Logan would appear to be a cannon. I asked him how all those magnolia blossoms got into your pool. He said the wind probably blew them off during the night. Then he fired at me.
Drum would never aim a gun at a lady.
He's a real gentleman. Sure he takes dishes out of sink before he pees in
them. That's what it's called for.
All I know is my animal has to be sedated. He has a condition.
Miss Weeza, are you sure that's true? Rhett is a very old dog.
I am simply going on what the vet tells me.
Well, Daddy's not trying to drive you crazy. He's just trying to make my reception nice. His heart's in the right place.
But he can't do that to my dog.
Miss Weeza, I know for a fact there'll be no more gunshots. So why don't you relax?
Have some coffee.
Ladies, this is going to work out wonderfully. I am almost done with Shelby, and Elle can go on and shampoo Weeza. Life can be beautiful.
All right. Stay. As long as there are no more gunshots. Who the hell are you?
I'm an elf.
Fine. Are you new in town? I know everyone in this town, and I don't recall ever seeing you before.
I just moved to town just a few weeks ago.
With your family?
No, ma'am. I don't have any family to speak of.
With your husband?
My husband? Well, that's hard to say. I don't know.
You don't know?
Well, I'm not sure.
You're not sure? I'm intrigued. Are you mad or not? These are not difficult questions.
I don't know. If I'm married or not. I just can't talk about it.
Of course you can.
Well, I'm not sure. He's gone.
Honey, men are the most horrible creatures. They will ruin your life. Mark my words.
Everything is horrible. Bunky, that's my husband's name. We only moved here a month ago, and he just vanished last week.
No idea where he went.
Nobody knows. He took all the money, my jewelry, the car. Most of my clothes were in the trunk.
Well, there could have been foul play. Have you been to the police?
No, but they've been to me. He's in big trouble with the law. Drugs or something. He never paid the rent, so I got thrown out of our apartment and had to move in at crazy old Miss Robeline's. The police keep questioning me, but I don't know anything. They say my marriage may not be legal.
Well, you should have said something.
Well, I was scared to. I need a job in the worst way, and I didn't know if you'd hire someone who may or may not be married to someone who just might be a dangerous criminal. But I swear to you that my personal tragedy will not interfere with my ability to do good hair.
Of course it won't.
And I really don't think things could get any worse.
We are awful. We are all hateful, awful people. Here, all we've been talking about is weddings and psychotic animals. We've been tearing you up inside, haven't we? Well, I can't tell you how sorry I am. You've been through such a terrible time. Sometimes we don't know how lucky we are.
Well, honey, what can we do to help?
Well, I know one thing I can do. Tonight, you're going to come by my house and have some bling armadillo groom's cake. It's going to be a great party.
Oh, I couldn't. I still get real emotional sometimes.
Well, not today, you won't. Besides, I couldn't bear the thought of someone being unhappy alone tonight. And if you feel yourself starting to get sad, watch my husband dance. It's very funny.
You're all so nice.
Well, we enjoy being nice to each other. There's not much else we can do in this town.
Well, I don't have anything to wear.
No problem. I bet I have something that'll do. I'll go call the house.
Okay.
Oh, and now, honey, you should have told us about all this.
Well, what about Bill Bob's apartment?
Oh, yes, honey, I completely forgot. And now, if you are interested, you can rent my garage apartment. My son lives there right now, but he's going away to LSU in a couple days. Now, if you just give me a couple of days to straighten it up and sweep out the bed, I'm sure I'll be able to work something out with the rent.
Okay.
No problem. Shelby, honey, would you get off the phone? I have to finish curling.
Billing up from your backyard.
Well,
I hope nobody was hurt.
It looks like drums and all the trees.
me why.
I'm glad, Sugar. I'm not talking too loud, am I?
No, you're fine. Shelby loves you very much.
I hope so. This is our cost of $60.
I'm being serious.
So am I. I got the receipt right here.
Could I say this, please? I know when you're young, everything seems perfect. And maybe it will be. Just promise me you'll think about any decisions about family.
I know what you're saying.
Good.
Tell me why is your heart as cold as ice? Oh, is there a demon hidden just behind your eyes? Well, I dream someday you'll love me, but that dream just don't come true. But that don't keep me from wishing, cause I'm still in love with you.
Invited me. I don't know why I'm here.
Well, I'm Sammy. This here's the best cherry coke in the world.
I am not speaking to you.
Oh, what a shame.
I mean it, Rob.
We're not probably 3 to 10 minutes on your cheesecake.
Decorating that little tree over there, and when we plugged it in, all the lights blew.
We got nearly stuck from Monroe because we wanted to drop by Jackson's house, Jackson's parents' house. They leave the house at the crack of dawn on Saturday to start hunting furry little creatures.
Well, honey, you must not have visited very long.
Well, we didn't. I could tell they're anxious to start killing things. We stopped by the house first, and nobody was there. Where's Truby?
Well, they're still working on that tree over there, honey. Where's Jackson?
Well, you know how twitchy he gets. I sent him out looking for stocking stuffers.
Oh, such good thinking.
Jackson and I have something to tell you, Mama. We wanted to tell you when you and Daddy were together, but you're never together, so it's every man for himself. I'm pregnant.
Shelby.
Mama, I'm gonna have a baby.
I realize that.
Well, is that all you're gonna say?
What do you expect me to say?
Well, something along the lines of congratulations.
Congratulations.
Would it be too much to ask for a little excitement? Not too much. I wouldn't want you to break a sweat or anything.
I'm in a state of shock. I didn't think.
In June, Mommy, you have to help me plan. We're getting a new house. Jackson and I are going house hunting next week. Jackson loves to hunt for anything.
What does Jackson say about all this?
He's really excited. He says he doesn't care whether it's a boy or a girl or not. But I know he really wants a son so bad he can taste it. He's really cute about the whole thing. All he can talk about, Jackson Lattery Jr.
Well, does he ever listen? I mean, when doctors and specialists give you advice, I know you never listen, but does he? He might not be the one carrying the baby, but that doesn't mean it doesn't concern him.
Mama, I want a child.
Shelby, what about the adoption proceedings? You filled out all those papers.
It didn't take us long to see the handwriting on the wall. No judge is going to give a baby to someone with my medical record. Jackson even put feelers out about buying one.
Well, people do it all the time.
Listen to me. I want a child of my own. I think it would help things a lot.
I see.
I know.
don't think I haven't thought this through,
but you can't live life if all you do is worry, and you worry too much.
Some ways it's kind of a comfort to me because I never worry.
No, you're worrying enough for the both of us.
Shelby, why would you deliberately want to do this to your body?
Diabetics have healthy babies all the time.
But you're special. There's limitations to what your body can handle.
Mama, listen to me. I'm going to be very careful. And this time next year, I'm going to be bringing you a big, healthy grandbaby to the Christmas festival. Nobody's going to be hurt or disappointed or even inconvenienced.
Least of all Jackson, I'm sure.
You are jealous because you no longer have a say-so in what I do, and that drives you up the wall. You're ready to spit nails because you can't call the shot.
Shelby, I did not raise my daughter to talk to me this way.
Yes, you did. Whenever any of us asked you what you wanted for us, what did you say?
I'm not in the mood to play games, Shelby.
Tell me what you said, Mama. Answer me.
All I ever said was that I wanted you to be happy, Shelby.
Okay, and the thing that would make me happy is to have a baby. If I can adopt one, I would, but I can't. I'm going to have a baby, and I wish you would be happy, too.
I don't know what I wish, Shelby.
Mama, why do you have to always make everything so difficult? I look at having this baby as the opportunity of a lifetime. Sure, there may be some risk involved, but that's true for anybody. But you get through it, and life goes on. When it's all said and done, there'll be a little piece of immortality. Good look to my sense of style. Please, Mama, please. I need your support. I would rather have 30 minutes of wonderful than a lifetime of nothing special.
Trivy, they're on.
Oh, Mama, please don't tell anybody yet. I'm going to tell Daddy first.
I never tell anybody anything, Shelby.
Well, look who's here. Come and give me a hug right here and now. Oh, my goodness. Oh, hold on. Give me a hug in a second. And now I'm going to shoot that girl.
Well, hi, Trivy. Merry Christmas.
Oh, how are you, darling? And now we have a special mystery guest. You are right in time. You can light the tree of beauty.
Well, what a novel idea to decorate it with hair things.
Oh, that was all a nail's idea.
Hi, hair.
And now the wreath fell.
Well, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. That husband of yours, I tell you. And now, did you do all this?
I'm guilty. Trivy just turned over the decoration responsibility to me. I like things, and I despise the commercialization of Christmas. Always have. So I went to the fire sale at the Baptist bookstore in Shreveport last month. They had mismatched manger scenes at incredibly low prices. I cleaned them out of baby Jesus's, which Trivy's husband helped me modify into ornaments. Very simple. Tiny white lights, baby Jesus's, and spoilies.
My husband has redone Pooh's old room so Annelle can have a little workshop for all of her handicrafts. That garage apartment is so cramped.
Well, how nice. Trivy, are your boys coming home for Christmas?
No, honey. Louie brought his girlfriend home at Thanksgiving. The nicest thing I can say about her is all her tattoos are spelled correctly. I guess it's just me, the old man and the nail. Well, come over here, honey, and light this tree up. You can do the honors. Hope it doesn't blow up again.
Or what?
Oh, beautiful. I know what I'm doing.
Well, I know your mama is so happy you could make it home in time for the Christmas festival. This year, I hear it is going to be the best ever. There are going to be more fireworks, a nativity scene made completely out of sparklers, and a huge sign on the riverbank that says, I heart Twinkleton Parish. It is going to be spectacular. Shelby, honey, you will never guess who the grand marshal of the parade is.
Who?
Wayne Newton.
Well, I wouldn't miss the Christmas festival for the world. Oh, Mama, that reminds me. I brought you some white chocolate cherry cheesecake for the open house tonight.
Well, that doesn't sound like finger food to me.
Well, they're by.
A nail.
I'm sure you know what you're doing.
Perfect. Oh, and I've been cleaning out my closet, getting rid of stuff that I don't want that I've hardly worn. I thought your mental patients might be less disturbed if they had something stylish to wear.
The hair dryer.
Excuse me, Shelby. If you don't have any special plans for the clothes, could I have them? Ruby for you Baptist has a clothes closet for the poor. And we're really low on women's dresses.
Sure, that's a wonderful idea. Well, they're in the car. I'll get them out in a minute.
Okay.
It breaks my heart that you won't come to the Methodist church with me. Shelby, I think that Riverview Baptist is a little too praise the Lord for my kind of taste.
Yes, well, some of them do get a little carried away, but there is nothing wrong with that.
No, a lot of Mama's mental patients are born-again Christians. I mean that with the nicest sense of the word.
Well, we are just glad to see that our little Annelle is finally getting settled down. You had a couple of rough months there, didn't you, honey?
Yes, well, after they found their bunkie to play behind bars and I was rid of him, I went wild. I was running around and drinking and smoking.
Oh, Jezebel!
Oh, but Truby helped me see the errors of my ways. I realized I have something to offer. I joined the church last month, and Truby's helped me see that I have talent, too. I'm even doing guest lectures on beauty at the trade school.
Our little Annelle has become one of the hottest tickets in town.
Truby, stop. I'm enjoying the city much more, and I'm so excited about the Christmas festival today. I've wanted to come to it all my life, and now I live here.
Tell her who you have a date with.
Truby, hush.
Shelby is practically responsible for the entire thing.
Sammy DeSoto.
He has a body that doesn't stop anywhere.
Well, how am I responsible? He was bartending at your wedding reception last spring. That's when I met him. He makes a mean cherry coke.
Romance, this is what I live for. Shelby, honey, can we get you anything?
Miss Truby, I'm beyond help. Last week, I discovered the early stages of crow's feet.
Oh, sweetheart. Time marches on, and eventually you learn it is marching right across your face.
Well, how are you feeling?
Never better.
My angel pecan toffee.
There is my girl. I guess you're the happy one this morning.
Oh, honey, I am. Thursday, 15, 8 years.
Mrs. Clary, you sound awful. Can I get you some tea?
Oh, well, hello, darling. Yes, that would be wonderful. Well, honey, I am sorry I'm so late. We didn't get in till 1:30 last night, and I overslept. But let me tell you, it was a wonderful victory over dry prompt.
Yes, I heard you on the radio last night. You were wonderful.
Oh. Well, what were you doing on the radio?
Oh, honey, they let me be the color announcer for the devil.
I told you.
I was wonderful. I was too colorful for words.
Well, that was nice of them to let you talk on the radio.
Nice, nothing, honey. I own the radio station.
You bought it?
Yes. KPPD, the radio station of choice in Chicopee Parish.
Shelby, how do you like Clarice's new short and sassy look?
I love it.
Oh, just wait till I jack it up.
Miss Clary, it makes you look much younger.
Honey, my hair may look younger, but my face looks older than ever.
There is so much going on with the state championships last night, the Christmas festival today, and the Messiah sing-along tomorrow.
Life in the Big City will fool you.
What? Who's Miss Merry Christmas this year?
Oh, child, nobody.
Oh, this year, honey?
Well, it's my niece, Nancy Beth, of course.
Well, I should have known. All you Marmillions are gorgeous. Beauty's genetic in your family.
Well, how many titles has she had, Clarice?
Well, honey, she must be pretty because she won Miss Merry Christmas, Miss Soybean, and Miss Watermelon.
But, honey, she is dumb as a pole.
Empty as a head that wears the crown.
But you have to admit, God did do a little dance around that family. Drew is so successful. Belle does her own hair. Their children are perfect. They are like a family on TV. They haven't had a care in the world.
Well, who won the title your year?
Well, my year, honey. Nobody. There wasn't even Christmas festivals when I was in high school. Why, Jesus wasn't even born until I was a junior in college.
Miss Clarice.
Honey, I remember distinctly. We were watching a flock by night.
Clarice, shut up and get over that. Nell's got a gift wrap your head.
I could just get
good morning, Lisa.
Look what you're doing.
The parade doesn't start in 4 hours, and already people are parking on my grass. It will flatten my walls.
Honey, let me hold you. Well, hello.
Shelby, what are you doing in town?
Being a tourist, I suppose, but I won't flatten your grass, I promise.
Good God, you had the good sense to get away from here. I don't know why you dragged yourself back for a couple of firecrackers and teenagers arping on your shoes.
Well, I like it. Miss Wizard, I think you need a healthy dose of Christmas spirit.
I have so much Christmas spirit, I can prove it.
Well, Merry Christmas.
I just finished putting out my yard decorations.
Weeza, keep off the grass. The signs do not count as yard decorations.
They are murdered, Holly.
Oh.
You made them, didn't you?
With my own two hands.
Your present is back at the house. I haven't wrapped it yet.
Ladies, I've got to go finish my Christmas shopping, but before I go, Miss Weeza, I met an old friend of yours.
Oh.
Owen Jenkins.
Oh.
Owen Jenkins. Now there's a blast from the past. Do you remember him?
He remembers you.
Of course I remember him. He had the longest nose hair in the free world.
Well, he doesn't now. He hardly has any hair anywhere.
Oh. Owen Jenkins. He hasn't been here since God was a boy. I forgot he ever existed.
Well, now he lives in Monroe, goes to First Presbyterian. We sing in choir together.
Last week we were doing an especially beautiful Mozart piece, and I was moved to tears.
Owen offered me his handkerchief, and we got to talking. When he found out where I was from, he asked me if I knew you, and I said not only did I know you, but you were my neighbor, and your dog had almost killed my father on numerous occasions. He's had a very interesting life. He lived in Ohio somewhere, and he moved back down here when his wife died recently.
Does this story have a point?
Well, no, not really. He just remembers you fondly, I think.
Can't imagine why. He wasn't a bad fellow, but I managed to run him off and marry one of the first two total deadbeats.
Unrequited love. This is my favorite.
Well, maybe I can make us all get together sometime.
Maybe not.
Well, why not?
Shelby, I have managed in a few decades to marry the two most worthless men in the universe and proceed to have the three most ungrateful children ever to see. The only reason people are nice to me is because I have more money than God. I am not about to open a new can of worms.
Weeza, if you really feel this way, maybe you should come down to the Mental Guidance Center. We're there to help.
I am not crazy, Malin. I've just been in a very bad mood for 40 years.
Well, ladies, I've got to go do my Christmas shopping. And now, what do you want me to do with those old clothes?
Just bring them in.
Oh, you're going Christmas shopping? I could shoot you. I haven't even started.
Truby, I haven't even washed the dishes from Thanksgiving.
I'm not going to tell me what that girl's up to.
She's donating some clothes to the poor.
Sure hope the poor people are cheap.
Why do you say that?
Wait till you...
Shelby, just dump them on the couch, honey.
Malin, you sure you don't mind? I mean, if your patients need them, then...
Oh, no, that's fine. What Shelby says goes anyways.
Mama, that's not true.
Shelby always has to have the last word in everything.
I do not.
Hello, Merry Christmas.
Oh,
honey, is that new?
I made this with my own two hands and just kind of put the rest of it together.
Well, honey, the only thing that separates us from the animals is our ability to accessorize.
And now, honey, why are you so late? Did you and Sammy get tangled up in the tinsel?
Ruby, you kill me!
Oh.
Miss Weeza?
What?
There's somebody here to see you.
Oh.
I opened a can of worms for you.
Hail, Owen Jenkins.
Hey, Weeza, and me?
My God, you look different. Have you drunk?
You look terrific. You probably changed it
all. I'm not as sweet as I used to be. I cannot believe Shelby did that. Oh, honey. After all these years, I don't think I can be gracious under pressure.
Shelby does a lot of things I don't love.
Well, what's wrong with you these days? You got a reindeer up your butt.
Hey, everybody, come here. Gather around. It's only going to be a minute of your time.
This morning, my daughter told me something special.
Daddy.
Don't worry, Shelby. I ain't going to tell him you're pregnant.
Oh, honey!
I'm
going
to be a new granddaddy.
Oh, it's Malin.
Malin, congratulations.
Oh, Grandma. Well, smile, it increases your face value.
And those doctors said Shelby couldn't have children.
What do they know? I guess she sure showed them.
The doctor said Shelby shouldn't have children. There's a big difference.
This baby's not exactly good news.
Oh, honey. Well, I wish I had some words of wisdom, but I don't. So, I think we should focus on the joy of the situation.
Absolutely.
It'll all be fine.
Diabetics have healthy babies all the time.
Well, honey, you know what they say. That which does not kill us only makes us stronger.
Shelby will do anything to prove me wrong.
My new grandson. May he be as good looking as I am.
Didn't he scare you to death coming by so late?
Oh, honey, it wasn't that late. About 9:30, I guess.
Still, somebody knocking on my bedroom window after dark scared the daylights out of me.
Not me. Hope Springs Eternal, I suppose, but I was a little disappointed to find he was only my nephew.
Well, I think it's awful of Drew and Belle to throw Marshall out of the house. Parents should never throw their children out of the house.
Well, my brother Drew can be a little hot-headed sometimes. But he didn't really throw Marshall out of the house. Marshall just came to my house to give his daddy some time to cool off. I adore Marshall. We stayed up half the night just talking.
Well, I suppose I'm done. Are you ready to see the new Shelby Lactory?
I don't know.
Well, honey, it looks precious.
And you're going to have to see it sooner or later. Our world is full of reflective surfaces.
Well, I don't know why I'm getting worked up over something as silly as a haircut.
I love it. Are you ready?
Okay, I'm ready. Oh, gosh. Truby. So strange.
Oh, honey. Well, please don't start crying because, you know, I will too. I have a strict policy that nobody cries alone in my friends.
Ladies, please. Remind me never to take them to Dark Victory. They never survive.
Enough. I love it.
My autistic nature is so relieved.
It's very becoming. I guess with that baby and all, you don't have time to spend hours fussing with your hair.
Well, honey,
you need something you can just run your fingers through and go.
Well, honey, stop worrying. Your mama is going to love it.
Mama's going to freak out. Wasn't up to a big debate with her this morning. Now, Truby, let's do my nails.
Well, this is a treat. Nobody ever wants a manicure around here.
I don't even know what I'd charge for a full day of beauty.
I want the works. I want to feel totally pampered. Mama's going to want a manicure, too.
Well, I am going to paint my front door red and change my name to Elizabeth Auden.
Manicure, saucy new hairdos, what is going on?
Oh, we always have something going on. You know that. But what I really want to do is get back to all this Drew and Belle nonsense. I do hope they reconcile soon with Marshall. Speaking as a parent, they better get their act together. I do not approve of friction between parents and their children.
Oh, honey, I think it'll all blow over. Now, I have to admit, he didn't exactly go about it the right way.
Well, what did he do?
Well, he marched in unexpected from Los Angeles while Drew and Belle were preparing for the Mama and Trimble. And without so much as a hello, he says, Mama, Daddy, I've got something I've just got to tell you. I have a brain tumor. I have 3 months to live. Well, naturally, Drew and Belle became hysterics. Then Marshall says, hey, folks,
I'm just kidding. I'm only gay.
That was his idea, breaking the news gently?
Well, Drew became incredibly distraught. Started throwing wet shrimp at him and screaming at him to get out of his sight. Marshall came to my house smelling like a can of cat food.
What do you suppose Marshall and Dale are thinking right now?
Oh, honey, I don't know. They just considered themselves to be the model family for so long. First was Nancy Beth being dethroned from Miss Mary Christmas after that, unfortunate motel thing.
Uh-huh. What motel thing? I don't live here anymore, remember?
Well, honey, Nancy Beth was caught in a motel room with a high political official.
High? Honey, they were both high. They've been smoking everything but the shoes.
Nancy Beth has been the only Miss Merry Christmas in history to be caught with her tinsel down around her knees.
Miss Clary, how do you feel about Marshall?
Well, honey, I don't think too much about it. But you know what? He's always welcome to my house. I'm so proud of that boy. He built up that chain of sportswear stores all by himself without a penny of family money. He says, I am a self-made man. I pull myself up by my jock strap.
He could always turn a phrase. Amen. Amen. And now, honey, would you get me some more of this? I'm out of it.
Is it still next to the...
No, it's up in the...
Okay. Was she praying?
Yes, honey, she was.
Why?
You got me. Maybe she was praying for Marshall and Drew and Bill. Maybe she was praying for us because we were gossiping. Maybe she was praying because the elastic shot in her pantyhose. Who knows? She prays at the drop of a hat these days.
Well, how long has she been like this?
Ever since Mardi Gras. She had this choice of going on a Bible study weekend with her Sunday school class or to New Orleans with me and a couple of other sinners. Well, she left that Friday a well-adjusted, pleasant young lady and returned on Tuesday a Christian.
What does the boyfriend say?
And he's so confused, he doesn't know whether to scratch his watch or wind his butt. He's crazy about her. He says he could deal with another man in her life, but he has a little problem with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Well, I'm pretty religious, but that stuff makes me feel kind of creepy.
Well, sweetheart, I am torn. I have two sons that I'm afraid are going to hell in a handcart, and a semi-daughter who strives to be the kind of girl Jesus will bring home to Mama. I don't know. I've never understood those kind of people, but sometimes they do seem to have a peace about certain things. Maybe I'm jealous.
Oh, and honey, Marshall, he is so thoughtful. He bought me this pen. Look, it's gold and enamel.
Marie, it is a duck.
It's fine jewelry, Truby. And honey, its little eyes are made of sapphires, my birthstone.
Miss Clary, does Marshall have any, well, you know, friends?
Well, we talked about that. I'm such a nosy old thing. I asked him how he, met people. Because, you know, in my day and age, you could tell by a man's carriage and demeanor which side his bread was buttered on. But this day and age, you can't tell. So I asked him, I said, Marshall, how can you tell if he's, you know? And he said, well, all gay men have track lighting. And all gay men are named Mark, Rick, or Steve.
Good morning, Lisa.
What's so funny?
Well, Miss Clary was just telling us the true story of track lighting.
Oh, I love mine. It highlights my new artwork.
Since when do you have track lighting, Lisa?
About 3 weeks. It's in my foyer and upstairs. It was my grandson's idea.
I haven't seen him in ages. How is he?
I brought you all some tomatoes. First season.
Ooh.
Tell me your hair is so short.
Thanks, Miss Weezer. Jack Jr. loves tomatoes. He usually smears them on the cafe curtains.
Well, your mama says you have become an incredible gourmet cook.
Well, I try. When we were first married, all Jackson wanted was meat, potatoes, and vegetables. Cooked just the way his mama made them, to mush.
Oh.
But I've broken him of that and got some pate down him last week. Wore it with dog food. Jack Jr. loved it, though.
Clary, how many tomatoes do you want? Tomatoes that have no calories and are full of things.
Why, Weezer, you're off a chipper this morning. What happened? You ran over a small child or something?
Do you or do you not want tomatoes?
Well, don't give me all of them.
Why, have to give them to somebody. I ate them. I try not to eat healthy.
much as I can help it. The sooner this body gives out, the better off I'll be. I have trouble getting enough creases in my diet.
Then why do you grow them?
Because I'm an old Southern woman. We're supposed to walk around wearing ugly old dresses and funny looking hats and throw vegetables in the dirt. I don't know. But don't ask me. I don't make the rules.
Weezer, why don't you try wearing some gloves, honey? Your hands look like a couple of T-bone steaks.
Miss Weezer, health is the most important thing. Trust me on this.
And while I have everyone's attention, I went out to my mailbox this morning and realized that somebody has put me on the mailing list for the Riverview Baptist Church. I am now receiving chain letters for Christ.
They're not chain letters. They're part of my prayer group's Reach Out and Touch project. We were each supposed to write someone in the community that we thought might be in spiritual trouble and invite them to worship. It looks like you made everyone's list.
I think it is in the worst possible taste to pray for perfect strangers.
Honey, you reach out to Weezer and you'll pull back a bloody stump.
Oh, Shelby, honey, I just remembered you saved me a phone call. Sis Oral and I are coming up to Monroe next Friday night. We'd like to take you and Jackson out to dinner if we may.
Oh, Miss Cleary, I can't next Friday. I'm sorry. What's the occasion?
Well, this is going to sound a little silly, but we're coming up to the little theater. We got tickets to see a play.
I didn't know you saw anything that didn't have a goal posted either in.
Well, honey, up to now, I haven't. But Sis and I decided the other night at Bridge, we want to keep up. We want to expose ourselves to a little more culture, and that's a little difficult to come by in this neck of the woods.
Cleary? What exactly are you exposing yourself to?
Well, honey, I don't know. The last thing we saw was pretty good. It was, Shakespeare. You know what? When you get right down to it, he writes pretty straightforward stuff. But I have to admit, when they start hiding behind those curtains and putting those funny little fangs over the faces, now that can get a little silly. Sis fell for it, but I didn't.
Miss Orell is so dumb. She thinks Sherlock Holmes is a neighborhood.
Anyways, we enjoy it so much, we're planning a theater trip to New York.
New York, Clarie, I am green with envy. Promise me you will go to the Bloomingdale's on the first floor and come back and tell me everything. Woman's Day says it is impossible to go through that and not get made up.
Well, honey, just hold on to yourself. Don't get so excited. We're just talking. Besides, I am scared to death to get on a plane.
Oh, honey, it is just a piece of cake. You are safer in a plane than you are in a car. You just sit in the rear. That's the safest place to survive the crash.
Miss Weezer, you should go to Monroe with Miss Clary.
I am not exposing myself to anything.
Well, honey, you could broaden your horizons.
You broaden your horizons your way, I will broaden my horizons mine.
Well, I'm going to support the fine arts in our area, and I'm going to the little theater.
All right, check. I support art, I just don't want to see it.
It wouldn't hell if you, you know.
Clary, let's get one thing straight. I don't see plays because I can nap at home for free. I don't see movies because they're full of trash and nothing but naked people. And I don't read books because if they're any good, they're going to turn them into miniseries.
Miss Weezer, I'm surprised that you and Daddy don't get along any better than you do. By the way, how are things with you and Owen? I tried to check up on you two, but haven't been able to lately.
They're fine. I enjoy his company on occasion.
Well, I can report that the Sherwood Lord's delivery truck stops by her house at least twice a week.
Oh.
He knows I like fresh flowers.
Mm-hmm. And I can report that a strange car is parked in her drive at least once a week.
There, my secret's out. I'm having an affair with a Mercedes-Benz. Mm.
Now, Weeza, I have been dying to ask you this, but are you and Owen, well, you know.
Wait, honey, I have to get a mental picture of this.
A dirty mind is a terrible thing to waste, and not that it's anyone's business, but no, we are friends. He would like more, and I am dealing with that, but I hope that in my way.
Miss Weezer, you are playing hard to get. Honey, at her age, she should be playing beat the clock. But honey, she's just like her old dog. Both have trouble with their new trick.
Clary, there will be no trash talking in my shop.
I can't help it if men find me desirable.
Now, Shelby, honey, when are you going to bring that babies of yours by?
Well, I've got a picture of him right here.
Mm.
Oh, now, ladies, I just remember. Next Saturday, we're going to have to, make some time adjustments. I am going to be here all by my lonesome. Our little Linnell is taking a well-deserved vacation.
Honey, you going on a trip?
Well, yes, I am.
Well, aren't you going to tell us where?
No.
Please, Linnell, I don't know how I'll get through the week without this information.
You'll just make fun.
Linnell, you know I'm glad that we can go on and on about your spiritual growth. I just can't get enough of it.
Weaver, Anil has a nice little trip planned to Camp Crossroads in the Ozarks.
Camp Crossroads? Now, I've never heard of that. What is it?
It's in the middle of Arkansas. It's a Christian camp. There's just cabins, a chapel, and a dining hall in the middle of the mountains of the lake. I will spend the entire week in Bible study, prayer, and meditation. I'll be in the middle of nature, surrounded by the beauty of the Lord.
I know what I meant.
Weaver! Weaver, are you alone?
I'm just trying to find out more about this.
Now that's a laugh. She hasn't done a religious thing in her life.
That's not true. When I was in school, my friends and I was dressed up as nuns to go bar hopping.
Miss Weaver, I have to say this, and I don't mean to hurt you, but I worry about your face sometimes.
My face is fine. It's my hair that needeth the most work.
Weaver. One of these days, someone is going to cut the feet out of your stocking.
Weaver, have you no shame?
It's all right, Truby. I love Miss Weaver. I pray for her every day, sometimes twice.
Morning, everybody.
Hi,
morning.
Truby.
Oh, Mama, don't say anything. I like it. I really do. It'll be so much easier to deal with.
Oh, honey, bless your heart.
Well, it'll dry so fast, I just have to run my fingers through it and go.
I love it. I do. How are you doing, honey?
I'm fine, Mama. How are you?
I'm good. Here, I brought you a little goodie.
You can open it later. Well, Lynn, it must be nice having the entire family home this weekend.
Well, it's been rare indeed, but it's been a good treat. What's the occasion? Nothing really. Last week was Drum and I's anniversary.
Oh, honey, why didn't you tell me? I could have fixed you something. Drum loves my nut surprise cake.
We've never considered it a major occasion before. Which one is it? 30th.
Oh, that's a big one. What is the 30th anniversary?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, you know, the first anniversary is paper, the 20th is china, 25th is silver, 30th must be...
Volume.
Malin and... What would Drum say if he heard you say that?
Nothing. The man prides himself on never having any tension, which is amazing considering the amount he's created over the years. Listen to me, taking pot shots on Drum. He's a good man. He might be crazy, but he's a good man.
He's behaving himself lately. He was most civil at the paper's meeting. I smiled before I could help myself.
Well, the most bizarre thing has happened. Drum and I seem to be rediscovering those things that brought us together in the first place. I don't know. I don't know if we buried them or just became blind to them.
Used to, the thought of my parents being romantic made me and my brother sick to our stomachs. But now, I think it's kind of sweet, and it's been a lovely week.
Well, we keep finding these moments of magic. I don't know. I don't know if I'm lucky to have what I have or just lucky to know what I have.
Please, this is getting too deep for me. I'm going to have my tires rotated.
Miss Weaver? Lillian, you know what I think you should do?
I believe you should write a romance novel. I could help you with some of the dirty parts.
No one would believe it, Truby.
Shelby, honey, you look a little pale. Are you doing okay?
I'm fine, Mama.
Well, ladies, if you're out and about this afternoon, you need to stop by the Dixie Plaza Shopping Center. My radio station, KPPD, is sponsoring a summer fiesta. There's going to be lots of prizes and a live band. They call themselves the Single Bullet Theory.
Oh, Shelby, what have you done to yourself?
It doesn't hurt.
Malin, have you seen this?
Yes.
Honey, what have you done? It looks like you've been driving nails up your arm.
Well, the doctors are trying to strengthen my veins. They're in terrible shape.
Well, then, what is going on?
Should we tell Mama?
Well, I guess so. Shelby's been driving nails up her arm.
Malin!
Stop that.
It's my dialysis.
What?
Dialysis. It's when...
I know what it is.
Please tell us what's going on, honey.
It's no big thing, no big thing.
Well, don't look at me like that.
How long have you been doing this dialysis?
A couple months.
Mary Lynn Eatonton, I am without words. Why have I not been told?
Well, there was no point. Sometimes you just don't want to talk about these things.
Well, Sheldon, we could have done something. Why didn't you tell her? This is selfish.
Hold it. You all are talking about this like this is something.
This isn't something.
Having Jack Jr. put too much strain on my kidneys and now they're kaput, that's all. The doctor said this would probably happen.
That's all. That's all, she said.
I'm responding beautifully to dialysis. Do I look bad?
No, honey, you look beautiful, but I was
just let us know what's going to happen. Do you do this dialysis forever?
Well, I could, I suppose. That's not real convenient when you're trying to keep up with a 15-month-old ball of fire. So I'll just have a kidney transplant and I'll be fine.
Is it that easy?
Sure, they do them in Shreveport all the time, 3 or 4 a week.
They do. Our Sunday school was just praying for one the other day.
But the hard part is finding the kidney, isn't it?
Oh, I saw something about this on TV last night. It was most dramatic. These medical teams go flying around everywhere, taking people's hearts and kidneys and who knows what else. And you know what impressed me the most? They carry them in beer coolers.
Stop that, Clarice.
Well, honey, I wouldn't joke in a moment of seriousness there. They do. Those men pull out the six-pack, throw in some dry ice and are hot and get on the plane.
They do.
But you never know when one will pop up, do you?
No, I'm registered on the nationwide transplant computer.
Well, how long do you have to wait?
There's some people on dialysis who have been waiting forever.
That must be agony.
Well, I suppose, but I'm lucky. I don't have to wait any longer. Mama's going to give me one of her kidneys.
What?
Well, when? When?
We check in tomorrow morning.
You're giving Shelby a kidney in the morning, and you haven't even said anything to any of us?
Ruby, I'm in a bit of a rush. Why don't you do my hair?
Ladies, I never thought there'd be a time when that wild was without words, but I think we found it.
Why didn't you tell us about this?
We haven't known very long. We were all tested last week, and I'm the closest match.
What do you mean, match?
Well, there's 4 categories, and I match the best.
Categories?
Swimsuit, evening gown, talent, and personality interview.
Shelby?
I am going to yank you bald-headed, smarty.
We are very upset here.
I'm sorry, that was Tommy's joke. I thought it was very funny.
Well, I'm just glad it was me. I would never want the boys to have to go through with this. And who would want one of drums mean old organs anyway?
Not really for me. My operation's the easy part. Mama's is awful. They basically have to saw in half to get the kidney out. Hers is major, major surgery.
They have to saw you in half.
Well, Truby, they do it on Circus of the Stars all the time.
Malian, this is no laughing matter.
Miss Clary, trust me, there have been more than enough tears.
Well, the best part about all this is I've discovered I'm going to have a smaller waist. They're taking out my 2 lower ribs.
You know, that's true. Cher had that done to make her waist smaller.
Truby, that woman is out of her mind.
Look, Shelby, earlier I said something about that I'd be better when my body gave out. I didn't mean that.
Miss Weezer, forget it.
What? I'm a terrible person.
No.
No, you're not, Weezer. You give your dog a kidney if he needed one.
Absolutely.
But you two seem so calm and collected.
Well, I'm happy. I really am. Most mothers only get to give their daughter life once, and I get to see it twice. I've got 2 kidneys, and I only need 1. I'm just glad we get to get it over with before it gets too hot outside.
Ain't that the truth?
I'm going to postpone my vacation today so I can sit with your husband during the operation. I can run and get colas and things.
Oh, Annel, you're so sweet, but you don't need to do that.
We'll make sure her family has enough food.
Yeah, honey, don't worry. We'll take care of everything. You just put the house out of your mind.
Oh, thank you, Clary. That means a lot to me, and Drum, too.
Malian, you are very brave.
You know, Shelby, if I didn't know better, I wouldn't think that you'd ever been sick a day in your life.
And now, that's the biggest compliment anybody's ever paid me.
Poor Shelby.
Don't say that. I have my baby, and I'm very happy. This is the price I have to pay. Then I can pay it. I can deal with it. Now, if I'm not mistaken, somebody has a present to open.
Oh, is that for me?
Well, only if you can wear a size 4.
I could take it in.
Can you help me?
Oh, yes. Here, honey, I'll help you.
It was on sale, truthfully.
Lady.
Will I look fabulous or what?
God bless you, Shelby.
You are going to be the sassiest girl in that hospital.
Well, Truby, what about me?
We'll get you some.
You ladies had better come visit me.
Oh, honey, I will. Now, Shelby, I'll be right there by your side when you wake up. And you'll assume, Lynn, you know I have connections.
Mama, we are in such good hands. I'm going to go back to the house and spend some time with Daddy. I know you're going to be a while. Truby, could I ask you a question?
Why, sure, honey.
I know this may be kind of gross, but could I have my hair?
Oh, no, honey. That is not gross at all. People do it all the time.
Well, I've had it for so long, like it represents an error or something.
Well,
no, wait, honey.
I'll get it and put it in the box. I'll give it to your mama.
Thank you. I love you all.
Here's one.
Were you holding him?
And you're looking at him, and he's looking at you, and then you both looked at me. Remember, Shelby? Or how about this one? At the Christmas party? You and Jackson? Or this one? Me, you, and Drum at the beach. Shelby, open your eyes. Open your eyes, Shelby. Open your eyes.
Baby, I can't. Well, I could put you in first thing Monday. Fine. Yeah. See you then, Susan.
39 degrees outside. You're right, Truby.
This weather's too cold for me. I'm going to write a letter.
I don't like it one bit. I turn blue when it's cold.
And Bolin had six fingers.
Who's Anne Boleyn?
Anne Boleyn. She was one of the six wives of Henry VIII.
I don't watch public television.
Says here she had six fingers.
Well, what happened to the other four?
Honey, she had 11 total.
What are you talking about, Clary? Are you trying to confuse me?
Well, it says here in this article that she had six fingers on one hand, so she had all of her dressmakers make a sleeve to come down over her fingertips so she wouldn't look weird.
Reader's Digest is a font of useful information.
My feet feel like two blocks of ice in here.
That coffee there tastes like it was made in a rubber tire.
But now, did you remember to get that thing for the Mr. Coffee?
Oh, I'll get it tomorrow. Have any of you seen her today?
Well, I stopped by there first thing when I got in, but only the boys were there.
Do you think she'll come by?
I doubt it. So her hair is the farthest thing from her mind.
Weeza, I don't know what is on her mind, but I just wanted to be here in case she needed anything.
Honey, I'm so glad you stayed open.
Clary, how were the boys?
As well as can be expected.
My husband and I are taking barbecue over there later.
Honey, but they have enough food. There's so much food.
Well, you can never have enough at times like these. Sammy's back at the apartment cooking up a storm right now. He's convinced that his red beans and rice will make everyone feel better.
I hope so. I reckon that's why they call it soul food. And now, remind me to get his recipe.
Well, you'll have to ask him. Sammy runs me off whenever he starts cooking. That kitchen is so tiny, he's afraid he'll hit me in the stomach with a spatula.
Honey, when are you moving?
Next month.
There you go. Often talking about that just when I'm about to be a semi-grandmother.
Truby, it's just on the street, just a hop, jump, and a skip away. You know that apartment is so scorched, Sammy and I have to step outside to change our minds. You're toying with me, aren't you?
A little bit. Not a lot. I guess it's just me and the old man now.
Truby, you know you love him, and you know that you would miss him if something ever happened.
You know, he actually got up off the couch last night and said, let's go out to eat. Well, after I came to, I asked him, what is the matter with you? I thought Deputy Dog had been preempted. Then he went on to inform me that he might get the electric contracting for the new college library. I am not supposed to tell anyone.
Morning, everybody.
Good morning, Malia.
Well, how are you doing?
Thank you, Anel. I'm fine.
Truby, do you think you could work a little work? I know it looks like I've been down a brick road.
Oh, honey, just let me
get my fairy dust
on. How are you feeling?
Well, I'm fine. The boys got in last night. I really don't know how they're doing. The drum is... he's not taking this role at all. Jackson is. Jackson. It's hard to be somber with a little baby running around.
Well, your hair is holding up beautifully. All I need to do to it is a lick and a promise. Did you have it done in Shreveport?
No, I did it myself.
Hold it, Missy. I don't want to hear that kind of talk.
It was so odd. I had no idea about the back.
Well, it looks wonderful. All I have to do is smooth out a couple of these rough spots. Actually, I'm going to need some temporary help when Anel goes on her maternity leave. Are you interested?
Truby, I'd love to, but I don't think I can with so much going on. It was so weird this morning when I woke up. I didn't know if I'd want to come here, but I just wanted to come here more than anything.
Well, that's not weird at all, honey.
I better be going.
Honey.
Lynn. Owen wanted me to tell you, you're in his thoughts.
Honey,
I didn't think you and Owen were.
He's coming in Monday to take me to Shelby's service. That girl will do anything to get us together.
If you need anything, you promise you'll call me?
And if her line's busy, you call me.
And honey, you can call me. I just got called waiting.
I will. You holding up, honey?
I'm fine.
It was a beautiful service. The flowers were the most beautiful flowers I've ever seen.
They were beautiful.
Malian, it should make you feel better to know that Shelby, she's with her king.
Yes, Nell. Maybe so.
Then we should all be rejoicing.
Well, you go right on ahead. I'd rather have Shelby here with me.
Malian, I don't mean to upset you by saying that. You see, when something like this happens, I pray very hard to make heads or tails of it. I think in Shelby's case, she just wanted to take care of that baby, of you,
of everybody she knew. Her poor body was just worn out.
It wouldn't let her do everything she wanted to do.
So she went on to a place where she can be a guardian angel. She will always be young. She will always be beautiful. And I personally feel much safer knowing that she's up there on my side. I know people might think that I sound real stupid. Maybe I am. That's how I get through things like this.
Thank you, Annel. It's a good idea. I don't know. I just don't think I can. I wish someone would explain it to my heart.
Drum said you never left her side.
No, I couldn't leave my Shelby. I just kept on pushing like I always have where Shelby was concerned, hoping she'd sit up and argue with me. But then we gave up all hope. And that's when they turned off the machines. Jackson left. He couldn't take it. Drum left too. It stuck me amusing. Men are supposed to be made out of steel or something. But I couldn't leave my Shelby. I just sat there pushing like I always have where Shelby was concerned, hoping she'd sit up and argue with me. It was the most precious moment. I was there when this wonderful creature drifted into my world. And I was there when she drifted out. I have to be getting back. Does anybody have a mirror?
Does anybody have a mirror? Well, honey, I don't know how your insides are doing, but your hair is holding up beautifully.
Shelby was right. It does look like a blonde football helmet.
Oh, honey, are you all right?
I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm fine.
I can jog all the way to Texas and back, but my daughter can't. She never could. I want to know why. I want to know why Shelby's life is over. Is that baby ever going to understand how wonderful his mother was? Will he ever understand? Lord, I wish I could understand. I'm so mad. No.
Christian thing to do.
And you, Annel, you need to lighten up, honey. Weezer, you know I love you more than my luggage.
Get off my bench.
Well, get off my bench!
You are too twisted for college TV.
Well, I know.
You need to have your roots done.
Sorry I went on like that. I made everybody cry.
Oh, don't you be silly. Laughter through tears is my favorite emotion.
Malin, tell your family they've been in my prayers. Yes, and now I pray.
I have suspected this all along.
Ugh. Well, don't you try getting me to go to your church or one of those tent revivals with all you Bible beaters doing God only knows what. You probably make me eat a lot of chicken.
Not on your first visit.
Very good, Annel. Spoken like a true smartass.
Oh, Malin, I don't know if this is the time or the place, but as you know, Sammy and I are having a baby. We've decided that if it's a girl, we'd like to name her Shelby, since Shelby's the reason that we met in the first place. If you don't mind.
Oh, mind? Honey, Shelby would love that. Well, honey, what if it's a boy?
Well, I guess we'll name him Shelby.
That's the way it should be. Life goes on.